Good morning. We're speaking this morning to Grant Ellis, the Chief Financial Officer of ASX-listed New Zealand company Restaurant Brands. Good morning, Grant.
Yeah, good morning, Blair.
Grant, I wonder if you might start by telling us about Restaurant Brands and what you do.
Yeah, well, Restaurant Brands, we're a quick service restaurant operator. We run four brands in three different countries where we operate KFC, Pizza Hut, Taco Bell and Carl's Jr. And we're effectively a licensee and we run those brands by taking the intellectual property of the franchisor and making it work in each of the three different markets that we operate. We've got nearly 300 restaurants across those three markets in New Zealand, Australia, and the US or Hawaii. Nearly 10,000 staff, and we will be doing $1 billion turnover. So a reasonable size operator for a company that just sells fried chicken, pizza, and the occasional burger. So it's a big business, the food business, and we're very much a part of that in, as I say, across those three geographies.
Yeah, it's quite incredible to think that all of that fast food across New Zealand, Australia, and in parts of the US is run by a New Zealand company in Auckland.
I think, as you're aware, we've the Hawaiian business operating very successfully, and we're about to complete the acquisition of a 70 store business in California as well, so 70 store KFC business. So we're well and truly bringing it back to the US in terms of the home of KFC in particular.
Yeah. That's incredible. Just turning now to what we've experienced through the COVID period, I'm sure this has created a number of challenges for you. How have you managed through this period?
Certainly personally, it's been an interesting reorientation for not only me, but for, you know, obviously most of our above store staff, learning to operate effectively from home. And I'd have to say, despite some of the downsides of working at home, it has actually been quite productive. And you know, you get used to talking to a large number of talking heads on your screen at various meetings. But you do have a lot less interruptions working from home, and you actually do operate efficiently. So personally, putting aside the sort of lack of direct social interface with your workmates, it does work very well. And of course, given the fact that, you know, we now have big chunks of our operations offshore, I'm personally well used to running, having business meetings online. There's been a few challenges, but and as you can see, I'm back in the office now. But it's certainly rewoken my perhaps desire to work a little bit more from home even with the end of the crisis.
Yes, that's interesting, isn't it? Right. I'm also back in the office, as you can see. But certainly adapting to working from home, I think will change a lot of our work practices going forward. Yeah. Do you see, you know, when we come back to a state of relative normality, that many of your staff also may be changing their work practices?
Yeah, we're looking now at, if you like, formalising that a bit more. Just, we've got a working group going here and just endeavouring to sort of find that what works best for our people and what works best for the business in terms of office place home balance in terms of location, and so we'll be developing a policy and process by which we will be absolutely allowing more people to work from home. And particularly, again, with our businesses, our offshore businesses, as we get more and more of our centre of mass moving out of New Zealand, with growth in Australia and growth in the US, those time differences do mean that working from home is provides a much better opportunity to, you know, engage with our particularly our US people within time zones that work for them as well as us.
And turning now, you know, to the business itself. So I imagine that you must have experienced quite extreme variations in cash flows, given, you know, for a period in New Zealand at least, all takeaways were shut down for around a month. And not only that, when they reopened, there were scenes of mile-long queues and people queuing up through KFC's drive-through of an hour and a half. Including me, actually, my kids were really hanging out for KFC costs and then drive through an hour and a half to get it. And so from a business perspective, that must have proved to be very challenging.
Yes, it certainly was. Sort of closing the entire New Zealand business down for 5 weeks, like any other business that gets zero top line revenue, that certainly puts fair amount of pressure on your cash flow. Fortunately, we'd just completed a complete renegotiation of our banking facilities and a big increase in our in those facilities in preparation for settling this US acquisition. So we had plenty of headroom to work in, and you know, we're obviously well funded, and so there wasn't any stress on our liquidity or funding capabilities. But clearly, you know, you don't like to have zero revenue for that amount of time, and we obviously continue to pay our staff, and that helped, and certainly the government grant helped in New Zealand as well. I think the other thing was we're very lucky that we had started to diversify our geographic operations. You know, 5 years ago, New Zealand was 100%, and 100% closed down would have fundamentally a huge effect on the business. But as you probably know, Australia continued to trade. So our Australian business, we had to close some stores that didn't have drive through, but the bulk of our Australian business continued to trade. And in Hawaii, both businesses, both the Pizza Hut and the Taco Bell business in Hawaii, traded, and in some cases traded very well. So the diversification helped sort of cushion the blow, if you like, of having a complete closure in New Zealand. From a sort of management and staffing point of view, absolutely, the reopening was a challenge. And you know, we know the great thing about our brands is that, you know, our customers have a passion for them, and KFC-less in particular for nearly 5 weeks created a huge pent-up demand on reopening. And and as you say, with the best will in the world, unfortunately, you know, there were big queues. And most, by and large, our customers were very, very patient, and certainly our staff put in some very long hours and some very hard work to try and satisfy the initial demand. And now that stores are by and large opening, although we still don't have dine-in opening, but certainly the initial flush of getting the KFC fix is over, and we'll settle down to a more normalised and stable sales levels over the next couple of months.
Yeah, that's good to hear. So hopefully we'll be back into level one and have those stores open again across the country soon. Thank you so much for your time this morning. I really appreciate it. All the best, and have a great day.
My pleasure, Glenn. Nice talking.